this opening animation. Johnny on the spot.
Hey, here we are.
I love it. It's showtime. If you've never seen the segment before, I am going to give Johnny basically something that he has to argue. So I'm going to give you a situation, and you have to say why that is the case. You have to make the case, essentially, right, for some of these points.
Let's go.
You're pretty good.
I like debating.
I mean, you can pretty much argue anything, as everyone that works here knows around the office.
You paint such a flattering picture, Jackie.
Yeah, MJ never shies away from a debate in the office. We'll just put it that way. Okay. Nor do I,
no,
to be fair. Okay, first up, there's no need to protect first-year goaltenders.
That's right. With all this talk about Carter Hart, what are we going to do with Carter Hart? How can we call up Carter Hart? We're on our fourth, fifth, sixth goalie, but I don't know. Can we? He's a professional athlete, Jackie. He's a pro. He's not eligible for junior. This is his job. And while I understand the development curves, sometimes if you're the best centerman and guys get hurt in the NHL team, you get called up. If you're the best defenseman and guys get hurt in the NHL team, you get called up. If you're the best goalie, or in this case, the sixth best goalie, and Carter Hart, I think, is at least that for Philadelphia, then you get called up. If you're supposed to be as good as he is supposed to be, if you are already a professional, this is your job, this is what you're aspiring to get to, then just let him get there. Put him in the NHL. You don't have to protect him, coddle him, make sure he's okay. You want to develop him carefully, professionally, like you would any positionable player. But let's be honest, he's just a goalie. He's not going to the moon here. It's the same game. He's just playing hockey. Don't need to protect him. Get him in the net.
I like it.
Time is right.
Because a lot of people talk about, oh, like if they bring him up too early, they'll ruin him.
Well, what are you going to do?
You can't ruin a good player, I don't think.
And he's going to be, if you're going to be a goalie, you're going to be strong mentally anyways.
Fair enough. Yes. Okay. How about the Blue Jackets? They are in quite a situation in terms of Serbei Bobrovsky and Artemi Panarin. Yes, many would call it a pickle. Make the case that they should trade not one, but both of them, even if they are in a playoff spot near the deadline.
Let's take a look at last year in the New York Islanders for an example as to what not to do with John Tavares. They could have elected to trade him, restock the cupboard, get all kinds of assets. What you have to do is be realistic. Are we winning the Stanley Cup this year with these two guys if they're not going to re-sign? And if they don't sign by the trade deadline, then I'm not feeling very good about them coming back? The answer is unlikely. Very unlikely. And you have a pretty good backup in Korpisalo. Can you imagine the amount of assets that the Columbus Blue Jackets could acquire in trading a Vezina Trophy-winning goalie in Sergei Bobrovsky and the most dynamic wingers in Artemi Panarin at the deadline? They would get a windfall. And so it's not necessarily for the best for this year. Of course, their team wouldn't be quite as good. But you'd get players that would help you this year. You probably would make the playoffs anywhere if you're going to be right there at the deadline. They're good enough to do that. And you would have a core group of young stars that could grow with Werenski and Jones and Pierre-Luc Dubois and really become a Stanley Cup contender for the next 5-7 years without worrying about your best players not wanting to be there because they can't go anywhere for 7 years anyways. It's a tough decision to make. I know it would not feel very good for the fans, but it's probably in the best interest of the franchise long term, and it would not crush you this year. They still would make the playoffs. They'd still get that experience.
Yeah.
And they'd be so much better set up than having these guys walk for nothing in July.
Yeah, I think unless you believe that you have a legit shot at winning the cup, you can't lose them for nothing.
Nope.
Because they're worth too much.
And that's where you have to be honest with yourself. Are we one of those five teams?
Yeah, like,
they're
are
probably
we?
Not. So yeah. Since they're probably not, then I think you got to go the long-term prudent play, even though it maybe stinks right now.
I agree with you. All right, how about Alex Ovechkin? Not even halfway through the season, he's already got 29 goals. So make the case that the Great Eight will score 60.
Have we seen him score 29 in 32 games? So let's just run the math. You know how much I like the numbers, Jackie. So he's got 50 games left.
Yes.
He needs 31 goals. Basically 0.6 goals a game over 82 seasons. That's basically a 50-goal pace. How many times has he scored 50 goals in his life? So many more times than he hasn't in the NHL. So all I'm asking for him to do is do what he's done more often than not. I think that's a pretty simple case, not even taking into consideration the growth, the maturity, the hot run, the great power play, the Stanley Cup championship on his mantle. All those things makes it, I think it's more likely than not he scores 60. All he needs is a 50-goal pace. Now, for any other player, that would be very daunting. That'd almost be impossible. But this is not any other player. And the other part about Alex Ovechkin, he's not afraid to go low. He won't get to 50 and say, oh, God, that's really good. That's nothing for him. That's just another year. He'll keep pushing. He'll keep pushing. He wants 60. He wants 65. And he's unique that way. Everyone loves to score, but he just will keep pushing no matter how high he gets. So I think he gets it.
It's crazy. The grayer he gets, the better he gets. He's like, he just keeps getting better season after season.
2 minutes for looking so good.
All right, one more for you. Make the case, and I did this last year and looked very silly. Make the case that the Penguins will not make the playoffs.
Are they in the playoffs right now?
Are they in a spot right now? They keep flip-flopping
They're
out.
They're in ninth. They're out of the playoffs. So they're already in the spot that I'm trying to say, what, they just have to maintain? And yeah, there's some gameplay permutations, but the biggest question mark for Pittsburgh right now is that they're not getting the goaltending they're going to need to make the playoffs. If you're going to think that Carey Price and Montreal can hang in there just a little bit longer to get a fourth spot in the Atlantic Division, then the fourth spot for the Metro might be very tough. And they're going to try to track down Columbus. They're trying to track down Washington. That's probably not going to happen. So maybe the New York Islanders, I don't know. Without goaltending, we've heard about the friction that may or may not be there, or that has always been there, but they've just kind of risen above it. Like every team, we've seen Chicago, L.A. Now, they're not in that case. They haven't on the downside of their window, but they're still getting a little bit older. They've had so much success for so long that at some point, it stops. And if you're not going to get goaltending as your team ages and your defense core is a little bit thin, then you will miss the playoffs. It happens. It's a very competitive league. There's all kinds of competitive balance. The Islanders are not going to take a backseat to you. The Canadians are not going to take a backseat to you. Leafs, Tampa, all those different teams, they will be in tough. They're already out of the playoffs now. I don't think it's a stretch to say they are out of the playoffs when the season ends.
It's going to be interesting. If there's no Penguins in the playoffs, that's going to feel weird. One more for you. Okay. I lied. That wasn't the last one. We got one. We're just having so much fun putting you on the spot. So now you get another one. Make the case that the Oilers will make the playoffs under new head coach Ken Hitchcock.
Okay, I'll make the case they make the playoffs. Their record with them is fantastic.
Yes, it is.
They have the best offensive player in the world.
Yep.
They have a goaltender that Ken Hitchcock has made look like Ed Belfour. His name is Mikko Koskinen, and he can't lose at home, and he can barely lose at all. And Ken Hitchcock has a way of grinding out points. He grinds you. It's not pleasant, it's not comfortable, but you find ways to win. He's also competing with a couple teams that I don't know are quite as good as we might have thought they would be. I think Dallas, Minnesota, Anaheim. Some of those teams that will be around that wild card spot, I'm not sure how good those teams actually are. They have a fighting chance to catch them. They're in the playoffs right now. And with Ken Hitchcock and the way that he can manipulate that roster to play a game that will get points with goaltending and Connor, they'll make the playoffs. Shouldn't be a surprise.
I feel like we need to make this harder next time we do Johnny on the Spot. You're pretty good at it.
Well, I mean, thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I mean, making a case for Pittsburgh missing the playoffs is not that easy.
No, that's true.